So we had several few items that we wanted to look at. The more important one was the presence of the police department and foot patrol. And so we were looking at how we could accomplish all this. Specifically, we want to look at the downtown area, and we also talked about the kids being in the police being in the school. What's the...
You can just put the top chart, unless you want EMTs.
Yeah, go ahead, the whole thing.
Okay.
You want the top?
Okay. And we were looking at how we're going to accomplish all this thing. Okay, what is she talking about? Well, she gives so much direction. All right, so one of the things that we looked at is for making the accomplishing the police presence is a lot of people are intimidated by the uniform, the gun, and everything. So we thought, well, policemen in plain clothes are, I think, I mean, we also mentioned that the school police wear khakis and, you know, things that don't make them look like policemen. So that makes people feel a lot safer and be more acceptable. We said uniforms make people uncomfortable. A lot of people just react normally. They just automatically just react negatively to a police uniform.
Who said that?
So how can we be successful in, you know, getting more visibility out there? Well, we could have some bicycle patrols. We used to have those, and for some reason, they were discontinued. And I think they even said that at Segway.
Yes.
For a while, they had a couple of them, and that was done away with. We can hire more policemen so we can have more presence, and we can take care of that problem. The crime rate in loitering, we want to see that reduced. There was a lot of debate going on about the loitering and what, you know, the laws and restrictions are and what you can or cannot do with someone that is a, quote, loitering. There is probably intoxication laws, but that's something totally different. And we see this a lot, especially like around Front Street, right around, like, for instance, the 7th and Park Avenue. I see that quite a bit with that hotel there close by. We talk about the public drinking. It's, that city ordinance has already been passed. I think you said that, Charles. When does that take effect?
It's the first reading.
First reading is about 30 days from now.
Mm-hmm.
About 30 days from
second.
Now?
Second.
Okay.
Second.
We want to also look at, there used to be a program to stimulate purchase of abandoned houses. These were offered to the police department and the fire department at a, what was it, a reduced cost or? Yes, and the only restriction was that they had to keep it for 3 years and then they could sell it. If they sold it before that, they could only sell it for whatever they paid for. Some of the obstacles that we see to accomplishing some of these things is the retirement and hiring is off kilter. They're not coordinated. You were saying that you retire 10, you hire 6. You retire 10, you hire 6. So that's always out of kilter.
Yes.
You're probably have the same situation in the fire department. Yes.
Absolutely.
So, and probably you're having a lot of retirements in the next couple of years or so.
It's going on right now.
Going on right now. I know because I was talking to the chief. My brother used to be in the police department in Houston, and that's what it goes through. You get them all hit you at one time.
Yes.
And the big problem there is you lose all that that experience, and you don't have the rookies, the experienced people to teach the rookies. So you not only lose the policeman, but you lose that expertise.
Yes.
In your policing. State exams and background checks have to be coordinated a little bit faster. I mean, you pass the exam and you're on the list, but the background checks then take a lot longer. So that has to be coordinated some way so that we can get both things in sync and get that done. This one created a little bit of a discussion. Is the residency of policemen in the city and firemen being required to reside in the city? We had a split on the table. Some people said they should be required to live in the city. Others said they should not. What was the one? You said you brought up a civil service. What is 1 year that's required? So That's gonna be, Charles, good luck with it.